let's learn about champagne. Now, first of all, let us understand that what are we going to discuss in this video. I all champagne, why champagne so expensive, making process with video, how to open a bottle of champagne, grapes used, sweetness level, and of course facts about serving. So let's begin the video. Okay, now the first question is, what is a champagne? First of all, we have to understand one thing, that champagne is a sparkling wine. But all sparkling wines are not champagne, but all champagne are sparkling wine. How? I'm going to explain you. First of all, I'll define it that champagne is a sparkling wine that comes from the Champagne region of northeastern France. See, if you will see the map of France, there are various sub-regions in France. Amongst those sub-regions, there is a region called Champagne, which is in the northeastern part of France. So if any of the sparkling wine will be produced in the Champagne region, then only it will be called a champagne. Just keep this in your mind, because this is going to be always striking you. Now, sparkling wine made outside of this region is sparkling wine and not champagne. See, if you bring any Tom, Dick and Harry wine which is not made in champagne, you cannot call it a champagne. It has to be simple. So one thing is absolutely clear, that is, all sparkling wines cannot be the queen champagne, of course. Now, when champagne is such an expensive drink and it requires so much of technicality in making process, we use three primary kinds of grapes. There are three primary grapes which is used in the process of making a good champagne. The first one is a Chardonnay, the second one is a Pinot Meunier, and the third one is a Pinot Noir. You have to keep this in your mind. These three grapes, Chardonnay, Pinot Noir and Pinot Meunier, only these three grapes constitute in making a champagne and no other grapes. So what are the grapes which are used in making a champagne? Chardonnay, Pinot Meunier and Pinot Noir. Now the next question is, why champagne is so expensive? Now you always give a head thought that, okay, champagne is very expensive. Have you ever tried to know that why it is so expensive? Because of its making process. Let's understand. See, the making of a good champagne requires a lot of expertise, a lot of experience, a lot of technicalities, a lot of mind, a lot of heart and a lot of brains are used in the making of a good champagne. And that entire process makes it a very, very expensive and sophisticated drink to take. So let's understand the process. See, this is not going to be unlike any other boring videos where I'll be writing theories and making you understand. After today's video, believe me for one thing, that you'll understand the making process for sure. Now the first process, and now of course this process is called the traditional method or the method champenoise. Now this is a very hot question which always comes in your hotel management exam, so you must learn it. So what is the making process of the champagne is called? It is called the traditional method or method champenoise. Now the first process in making a champagne is a primary fermentation. Now I believe that you know what a fermentation is. Fermentation is a very simple process where sugar is converted into alcohol with the release of carbon dioxide. I have made a lot of videos on this. You can go and take a reference, or you can just Google it. You'll understand what a fermentation is. Now after the primary fermentation, it results in a wine that is between 10.5 to 11% of alcohol by volume, and it is highly acidic. Now you see this video clip. You see how the fermentation is happening with the help of sugar, and the carbon dioxide is getting released. So the first process in making a champagne is a primary fermentation. Now the second process in making a fermentation is assemblage. Now as the word itself defines, what is assemblage means? Assembly, you know, bringing one thing from one place, another thing from the other place, and then mixing it together. So this is where blending occurs. Wines from different grape varieties, vineyards and vintages are all blended together. You know, we bring some wine from other place, we bring some wine from other vineyards, and then we mix it together, and then they're allowed to rest for certain time. Now you see this picture. A lot of wines are getting mixed together, and we are basically blending the wines together. Blending means putting tea into coffee. The coffee flavor gets blended inside the thing. The third process in making a champagne, which is a very important process, we call it liqueur de terroir. Now this is again asked individually in your hotel management colleges or interview. But this is where a measured quantity of cane sugar and yeast cultures are added to the mix to stimulate the second alcoholic fermentation. This takes place in a long neck dark green bottle with a crown cap like a glass beer bottle. Now, what happens in this process? Once the assemblage is done, we externally, we put some sugar and we put some yeast, the cane sugar and yeast we put inside a green bottle, and then we put a beer cap, a crown cap, which you, the kind of cap which you always see in over the beer bottle, we will put it with the yeast and cane sugar. And this brings up to the next process, which is called a second fermentation. Now, what happens in second fermentation? I'll explain you. Now, this occurs slowly within the bottle. The process can last anywhere from 1 to 3 weeks, and then the bottles are laid sideways to rest, mature and age. Now, after the assemblage, we have done the liqueur de tirage when we have added the cane, sugar and yeast on the bottle. Now, you imagine all the bottles are, first of all, you see this video, you'll understand what happens in second fermentation. All the bottles are placed horizontally, one over the other, and then there is a kind of protection in between with kind of wood or something. And then they're allowed to rest for some time so that it gets mature and age inside the bottle, because the bottle is already sealed with that crown cap. And it takes from 1 week to 3 weeks, and this second fermentation process is over. So by this time, we have already covered the primary fermentation. The second process was assemblage. The third process was liqueur de tirage. And the fourth is a second fermentation. So already four processes gone by now. Now, the next process is again a very important process, and it's again a very technical process. I'll explain you. This is called remuage or riddling. See, remuage or riddling, basically what happens that the bottles are placed in a canopy form in a kind of hole, and then we are mixing the bottle manually or mechanically. What is the reason behind this process? Because see, once in the previous process, in the liqueur de tirage process, what happens? We have externally added some yeast and sugar. So now the residue of that yeast will get collected on the neck of the bottle. I'll explain you a video in the later part, but you see, all the residue of that yeast will be collected on the neck of the bottle, because this prepares us for the next process, because we cannot serve a champagne with the residue of yeast particles, of course. So what happens that we will be putting the bottle like this, and then it will be allowed to rest for some time, you know, for some weeks or even for some months, so that all the residues get collected over the cap, over the neck, on the neck, you know, just on the edge of the neck, it gets collected. Now you see this video, and we are tilting the bottle at a frequent interval. It can happen manually and mechanically. I'll read it what it just said, that this is the process that requires twisting of the bottles to move the sediment towards the bottle cap. That's what I said, to get rid of it. This can be done by hand or machine and can take up to a week mechanically or 2 months if done hand by hand. This point is to get all the sediments to the tip of the bottle. The bottles are now stacked upside down in preparation for the next step. Basically, we are putting the bottle just to, you know, get the residues over the neck of the bottle. So this brings us to the next process, which is a very, very interesting process, and all the boys will relate to this process. I don't know how, I don't want to get dirty in this video, but this process is called a disgorging or disgorgement. What happens in the previous process, we have got all the waste materials on the neck. Now what we will do, we will flash freeze the bottle by putting inside a brine solution and certain chemicals. Those residues are frozen, and then we release the cork, and while we release the cork, all the waste material, it gets spilled out. That's why I said that all the boys are going to relate with this process, spilling out, you know. So this is the pro. Now you see, first of all, you see the video, you'll understand. You see, it has gone inside a frozen solution, a brine solution, and it has gone under a process of flash freezing, and then the cap is removed and all the dirty residues of that yeast is removed. Now this is the process of removing the gob of yeast residue that is now settled in the neck of the bottle. The neck of the bottle basically goes through a process of flash freezing. The lees are now frozen solid and can be carefully removed. The bottle cap is then popped open, and the CO2 pushes the frozen lees right off the bottle. Boom. Now you see, once we have removed the bottle cap, then because there is CO2 inside the bottle, so the pressure of that CO2 will remove that cap, and all those waste material or all the residue of that yeast will pop out. So this is the process called disgorging and the disgorgement. Now you understand one thing. Now this process, what we call is addition of the liqueur, liqueur the expedition. Now you imagine one thing, that in the previous process, while the cork was opened and because of the CO2, there was so much of pressure inside the bottle that all those dead yeast cells have gone out of the bottle. All those residues were gone. But it is not that God itself is opening the bottle. While the yeast was going out, there is certain amount of, you know, champagne has also spilled out of the bottle. Because once you are expelling the yeast out of the bottle, there are certain champagne also which has gone out of the bottle. So now we have to compensate that champagne which we have lost in the process of disgorgement. You understand? You picturize it. What happens that while we removed the cap, the yeast has gone out of the bottle because of the pressure, and while the yeast was going out, from the back some little amount of champagne also is lost in the process. So now we have to compensate that process. So that's why it is called addition of the liqueur, the expedition. So the bottle is now topped up with a small measured portion of additional champagne in order to replace the quantity that was lost during disgorging. Now this doses also contain a level of sugar that will determine the desired style of sweetness. You know, while the bottle is open and while we are filling a little amount of champagne inside the bottle to compensate it, we will also add a little bit of sugar. See, if you want to have a dry wine, we'll add less sugar or no sugar. If you want to have a sweet champagne, then we will add more. Accordingly, we will add a little bit of sugar also externally. That's why this process is called a addition of the liqueur, the expedition. Now when you see this small clip, you'll understand that we are externally adding a little bit of champagne and sugar. Now the next process, again it's a very important process, and this process is called recorking. Now you understand that once we have added the sugar and once we have added a desired amount of champagne inside the bottle, we must seal the bottle. Why to seal the bottle? So that the wine, the champagne is safe, there is less chance of spillage, or there is negligible chance of spillage, and also the quality of wine is retained. So now in this process, basically what we'll do, the bottle is now corked with a proper champagne cork and sealed with a wire cage. So you have seen that a champagne bottle has a cage over the cork, so we will just recork it. Now you see the bottle is going, a cork is there, and then we have placed it with a metal cage. So now the recorking process is done. So this was the entire process of making a champagne, and this is the only reason that why champagne is so expensive. Now we will understand some of the famous brands of champagne, which you are always asked in the interview that, okay, tell me some of the famous brands of champagne. So these are some famous brands. Of course, everybody knows Amouet, and then we have a Dom Perignon, and then we have a Piper Hyde Seek, then we have Bollinger, and then we have Paul Roger. Now there are hundred of n number of brands in the market, but this is something which is very famous, which you will always find in a good high-end bar. So you must learn these kind of brands, and they will make you good in your interview. Now let's try to understand how do we open a bottle of champagne. Now once you get used to it, it becomes very easy, but always for a beginner it is a little tricky to open a bottle of champagne. So let's see how we open a bottle of champagne. You see, first of all, the foil will be removed. Obviously we'll be removing the foil, and then we will be pressing our right thumb over the cork, you see. And then we will also be holding the bottle against our lap so that it gets secured, because there are a lot of CO2 and there are chance of accident. So now we have absolutely secured it, and we have put our thumb on the bottle, and then we have put the case down, and then we have moved in the reverse direction. Generally it is 6 backside movement and the cage, the wire is open, and then we have nicely captured the cork, and then we are removing again in the reverse direction, and we are feeling the ooze out of the carbon dioxide. And once the ooze is there, the ooze is lesser, we will pop up, boom, the bottle is open. So this is how we open a bottle of champagne. So cheers in advance if anybody is planning after seeing the video to open a bottle of champagne. And then there are some technicalities, the sweetness level in champagne. You must understand as a F&B guy that we have Brut natural, which is a bone dry, we have extra Brut, which is very dry, then we have Brut very dry to fairly dry, then extra sec, which is a medium dry, demi sec, which is a slightly sweet, and then we have Do, which is a dessert wine, which is very, very sweet. So, and now we'll understand some facts about serving. Now, what temperature we need to serve? Now, you understand one thing, that a champagne is always served cold, but we need to avoid extreme. We cannot serve it like a chilled beer, obviously. So, the temperature has to be anywhere around 8 to 12 degrees Celsius. Now, it again depends on the kind of champagne we are serving. So, if you are serving a non-vintage champagne, then it has to be between 10 to 12 degrees. And if you are serving a non-vintage, it has to be between 8 to 10 degrees Celsius. Now, 3 hours in fridge, 10 minutes in freezer, and 15 minutes in ice bucket, and you are good to go. Now, next is how much champagne, because we all know that if you are serving a red wine or a white wine, it has to be 150 ml. So in case of champagne also, it has to be a 150 ml serving, but generally whatever is the widest part of the glass, you have to fill halfway through that. Now, once you see a champagne flute, a similar kind of glass, so you have to serve till this way. So this was all about this video. Thank you very much for watching. And just for your information, the entire theory of this video, whatever it was in the slideshow, and also the wine series part 1, which came like a month back, both the theories will be available on my Instagram. And my Instagram ID is cbbioresume. So if you guys have not followed me, go and follow me there. You will find the theory, of course. So I hope you liked today's video. If you have liked the video, do share it with your fellow friends. And if you like similar contents regarding hotel management, hospitality, and about in this industry, then do follow me on my YouTube channel. This is Anand Mishra signing off. Take care. Bye bye.